Okay, so now we're going to talk about some additional variable characteristics. One important characteristic is whether a variable is qualitative, or quantitative. So a qualitative variable is one where the values are qualities or categories, whereas a quantitative variable has values that are numbers. And if you recall from the earlier topic about the scales of measure, these actually map onto the scales of measure pretty well. So if a variable is nominal, then it's going to be qualitative. If a variable is ordinal, interval, or ratio, then it's going to be quantitative, right? So these are categories like male or female, right? Ordinal, these are ranks like first place, second place, third place. Remember, intervals are numbers such as temperature in Fahrenheit. 32 degrees is when things freeze, right? 33, so these are numbers also. In ratio are things like inches or feet, so you could be 5 feet tall or 6 feet tall, and these are all numbers. Okay, so the next kind of variable characteristic I want to talk about is the distinction between discrete variables and continuous variables. All right, so discrete variables have specific values. There's nothing between them. So an example of this would be number of students. Right? You can have 0 students, you can have 1 student, you can have 2 students, you can have 3 students, but you can't have 3.5 students. So between the value of 3 and 4, there's nothing in between there. There's a jump. For continuous variables, on the other hand, there's any number of values between values. And with that, well, an example of this is height of students. So in between two values, such as 5'7" and 5'8", somebody's height could actually be in between there, and you could measure it. So somebody's height could actually be measured as 5'7.5", right? So there's any number of values here. And so these discrete variables, you can only be down here. You can't be right in the, so if this is a number of students, it'd be like 0 students, 1 and 2. You can have 0, 1 or 2, but you can't have 1.5 students. For the continuous variables, you can be anywhere along the line. And for discrete, if we compare these to the scale of measure, nominal variables are always discrete because you're always a category. You can't be halfway between two. Ordinal are always discrete because you have a rank, first, second, third, fourth, fifth. For interval and ratio, they can be either one depending on the specific example that you're working with. All right, and so I have one final characteristic of variables that I want to talk about, and this really relates to the scales of measure, nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. So this new characteristic of variables is it's called scale. So I know it's a little confusing. You have scales of measure, all right, these are the four scales of measure. And then, so a variable can be interval or ratio, and if it's either of these, it's scale. And if it's nominal or ordinal, it is not scale. And the reason that this is important is because the computer program we'll use for this class, called SPSS, when you tell SPSS what the scale of measure is for a variable, the options are nominal, ordinal, and scale. And so for scale, it's referring to either one of these two, interval or ratio. And the reason that it does so is, statistically speaking, these are interchangeable. And these are the kind of outcome variables we're going to be talking about almost exclusively in this class because it's an introductory level class. So scale is when the values are interval or ratio.